list connections through Craigslist. If you didn't know, there is a section on Craigslist where people will write postings, like, almost, I wouldn't call it like a little blog, but like short stories of encounters they have had with people, and like they didn't get their name or their phone number, but want to see them again. I think they tend to be more on the romantic side of connections, but I'm always really fascinated to see and read the ones that pop up, and so they made a compilation of them. short, you were very cute. I should have came over to you and gave you my number. You were wearing a light blue shirt and blue jeans. I was that bald guy in the orange shirt. Dylan, firefighter from West Islip, where are you? Dylan and I met in Penn Station Sunday at 5:45 p.m. I had just missed my train and Dylan approached me and started talking to me. Then he took me to Tracks for a drink. I was actually happy that I missed my train because I got to spend an hour with him. Dylan, I was so annoyed that you couldn't remember my name that I had to walk away. But then I decided, who cares? We're both completely sauced, so I went back, but you are gone. Maybe someone will see this and you can contact me. So Dylan, the runner, firefighter from West Islip, and I really don't care about your status. Waiting patiently. Saucy. Next section is called Dogs, Cats, Birds. Okay, this one is titled Bird Handler on West 50th. Wanted to say thanks for taking your time this morning to care for the dazed and confused bird that was grounded on the sidewalk. I was glad to see someone actually care about the poor thing, especially after the dismissive building guard started talking. It generally takes one person to pay attention to a small, beautiful thing for others to slow down enough to look, much less help. You did that, and it was a nice way to start the day. And thanks to Google, pushing through the brush across from these limestone cliffs. I heard a woman laugh as a dog jumped into the water after a ball. Then I saw you. It was hard to look away. Your skin, this beautiful light mocha color. You were wearing a white bikini. I was mesmerized. You were basking in the sun on a rock in the middle of the water. The trail ended close by, so I lay down in the sun for a while and watched the dogs play. On my way home, I saw you again further down the trail. You were again looking heavenly on a boulder in the sun with your dog. We looked at each other for what felt like an instant and an age. I don't want to disturb her moment, I thought to myself, and distractedly kept walking. But I was too caught off guard by how beautiful you were that I didn't realize I wasn't actually on the trail. As I debated going back to talk to you or not, I realized I was far off the trail. At that moment, your dog bounded right up to me. He stopped, looked at me, and then turned around to go running after you. That's got to be a sign for the universe, I thought, and I turned around to look for you, but your dog was too fast. And by the time I found the trail again, you were gone. sure why that was romantic. That's an odd one. Weird. Next one is called Montecito Pet Store Mesa Shopping Center last Friday. Or was it Saturday? Weekend event in front of Montecito Pet Store around 2 o'clock. You introduced me to a cute, lazy little gray kitty, only a little over a year old, but already had a mother cat herself. I know you were paid to be there, talk to the public, and showcase the cat, but you were quite friendly. I would have talked more, but was very self-conscious about my hair that afternoon. Bad hair day. I'm interested in going to one or more of the upcoming Campbell Hall screenings of Bogart Buckhall movies. Would love some company. No funny business. If you see this and would consider going, tell me the name of that kitty cat and I'll know you are no random so-and-so. Birdman at Matchless. You helped save a bird from a not-so-promising fate by climbing on top of a wall and safely returning it to its mother. Thus, you were renamed Birdman and will forever have a soft spot in my heart. Would like to discuss in further detail your future aspirations as a bird rescuer in the Brooklyn area. This next section is called Lust, so I'm a little nervous to read this one. We'll see how it goes. This one is called You Wore It Up Again. I am struck dumb by this attraction. Your eyes, voice, scent, curves, whatever, make me so weak. I just need to lay down for a minute. I usually can't shut up, but I see you and I have nothing to say. I'm afraid I'll keep talking and never stop. Please wear your hair down again. When I see your neck, I can't get any work done. With your hair down, you're merely breathtaking. I can handle asphyxiation, but I'm so afraid I'll touch you on your neck without permission one day, and I will have to endure the shame of becoming the creepy older man, semi-stalker pariah. The hopelessness of ever getting near you makes me angry at God. I write here because I can never approach you there. Interesting. Next one is called Music Moved Through You at Bembe. You danced. By God, did you dance? You wore a turquoise dress top over black tights. When you let down your hair and shook your head to the music, I felt like I was watching something so vital, feminine, sensuous, wild, and triumphant. A perfect expression of a woman. I was captivated. I could not dance with you and your friend. My guests, sardonic designers, could not set aside their irony to enjoy dancing. It was heartbreaking and ruined my evening, but you, please, never stop dancing. Circus Tales. Why is it that every time we get together, the two things we always do is argue and sleep together? Look, the time we went to the circus, we both argued about going because we're both animal rights activists, but we went anyway. I've got to admit, we had a pretty good time and looked kinda cute in our matching Ringling Brothers Barnum and Bailey circus t-shirts. We walked home along the river eating our leftover popcorn and cotton candy. Your powder blue circus tee contrasted nicely with the pink cotton candy, so I took a photo with my iPhone that we both posted on our Facebook pages. It was actually really nice, lingering on your bed and watching the sunset. Told me that the lions made you feel frisky. We made love like animals. On my way back from the kitchen, carrying a glass of fresh pomegranate juice, I slipped on that old worn out antique rug, the one you love. The one I always said was a dust trap. I spilled the juice all over your duvet cover. Again, the one I hate, but you loved. You told me how much you loved that duvet cover, now stained with pomegranate juice forever. I told you I thought the splotch of color was actually an improvement. That's when you threw a flurry of nasty curse words my way and told me to leave. I know it's only been a day, but I miss you already. I guess I don't quite understand that one because they knew each other. So maybe it's not just about people that didn't actually like exchange information. I'm surprised that one's in here, I guess. This is the final the bar and I ordered a mind eraser. Then I glanced at the dance floor and there you were. You were a tall, shiny, long-haired, stunning brunette with cosmic, hypnotizing light brown, radiant eyes that lightened up the dance floor. Your perfect, curvaceous, and hourglass figure complemented the dance floor. You reminded me of Kendall Jenner, but with a more enhanced body. And the way your curvaceous figure moved in sync and the rhythms of the dance music as every part of your body swerved and curved, unlike some without full body control. I couldn't keep my eyes off of you as the majestic splendor of your outright presence grabbed my attention. I purposely moved closer to the dance floor to get a better glance, but I saw you with a big group of friends. Is any of them your boyfriend? I hope not. Tell me what song was playing so I know it's you. Next one is called Yellow Coat at Zay Dunes. We were sitting next to you watching those people have sex in the window across the street. I thought you were ridiculously cute and your boyfriend's jokes were funny. You seemed bored and kept glancing over. I'm the non-Brit, hoping the other guy was your brother. Next one is called You Told Me You Liked My Chest. You came up to me and said you liked my chest. Unfortunately, my wife got in between us. I thought you were really cute and I'd love to let you feel it uninterrupted next time. These are bad. Oh my god. I do not condone cheating. Just FYI, you guys. I'm not okay with that. People are ballsy. Okay, the title of this one's funny to me. You wore a Darth Vader shirt and I brought the Death Star. It seemed like a match made in a John Cusack film. We talked for like an hour about Star Wars, Monty Python, Laserdiscs, New York City in the 70s, and Midnight in Paris. And I got a little sidetracked and never finished my story about seeing it while in summer exile in Austin, and I felt the spark. You waited until that point to mention your boyfriend, totally disregarding the 11-second rule. I really thought you were awesome until that moment, but we were both drunk, so who knows? So now I have to forget about you, so I'm writing this message in a bottle and dropping it into the sea of the internet. And this will be our last one. To the girl in the trees. We go to the same trucking school. I'm struggling to figure out life and where I want to be. You're a real man's woman. Too much for me to handle, at least for right now at my younger age, 25, although I'm fairly sure you are a year or two younger than me. You have the most perfect gray eyes and freckles that accent your bright and playful, almost boyish smile. You are tall and wispy, a trait which betrays to sight your physical strength and resilience. You have accomplished a lot, more than most women even today usually ever do, and yet you battle confidence on the field. You are the perfect woman for a more mature and aged version of me. You have a boyfriend and a bright, fun life. I have no chance in the possibility that someone such as yourself would be up on this random chance roulette is slim to nil. I am losing my hair a bit and wear a thin frame, German-style round glasses. My quiet and somewhat awkward nature hides behind a mind full of knowledge and eagerness to know people. If you know who I am, reply with the color of my mechanic's work suit, then I don't know what happens from here. Just write me back through the email on here. If you can figure out how, tell me how weird I am. Wouldn't be the first time. Otherwise, good luck with all the fun things life has to offer you, and for Christ's sake, try not to fall off the grain boom when you're cutting those trees, you adventurer, you.